Bobcat fans, and welcome to Bobcats Weekly. I'm Nolan Rich. Thanksgiving is almost here, and Quinnipiac fans are certainly thankful for their Bobcats and the start of men's and women's basketball season. But we start tonight with women's rugby. The Bobcats finished the season with a 6-1 conference record and entered the first round of the playoffs looking for their fourth win in a row. Bobcats hosting the Westchester Golden Rams, who the Bobcats defeat 100-10 last week. First half, floor pool will be caught from behind, but the no-look pass to Rebecca Height. She goes all the way for a successful try. Later, it will be Emily Roskopf as she could run all the way, and she does for another try, showing off the power run layer as Taylor Schussler is able to punch this one in for another try. And then later it's Leona Marr just dragging people along for the ride. Bobcats rolling this one by the final score of 84-7, in Quinnipiac advances to the semifinals of the tournament, which will take place this Friday at Brown University at 1 p.m. where they will take on Norwich University. Quinnipiac volleyball finished up their season at home with two games, looking to close out on a high note. First match against Iowa, Bobcats tied with the Gales in the third set as Elizabeth Kloos just squeaks this one past the defense for the point. Later in that same set, it would be Kloos again with a blistering kill, one of her nine on the day, to close out the third set. Later, Kaya Ricky with this great touch places it in between the defense for a point. Both teams going back and forth. Bobcats on the brink of a loss, but Kat Miller keeps the Bobcats alive. But the Bobcats just couldn't overcome Iona as they fall to the Gales in this one by the final score of 3-1. Kia Ricky led QU with 13 kills, with Chen Coffey adding 9. Bobcats wrapped up their season against Manhattan, where they fell by the final score of 3-0. Coming up on Bobcats Weekly, Alexa Farrell sits down with Quinnipiac women's rugby player Flora Poole to talk about how the team is preparing for their championship weekend. Later, both basketball teams tip off for the first time, and the Bobcats will look to get off to a fast start. Or would it be a foul weekend? We'll be right back.
Hello and welcome back to Bobcats Weekly. I'm Alexa Farrell. Each week we welcome a Quinnipiac athlete into the studio. And this week we're happy to have Flora Poole from the NCVWRA semifinalist QU rugby team. Flora, thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
So you've scored 184 points in the past two games.
Yeah.
That's huge. Why do you think your team is doing so well?
To be honest, I think it's because we're focusing so much on the basics. We're focusing on that and coming together as a team and playing as a team and finishing as a team.
Awesome. And what are you doing to prepare for the conference tournament?
It's going to be a tough weekend, but we have to be mentally and physically prepared. You know, going to sleep, getting enough sleep. It's a big week with homework and everything. And also eating right and physically looking after ourselves, going to the ATR and getting everything checked.
Well, I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
You'll get through the weekend.
Thanks.
When we come back, the QU men's ice hockey team was looking to remain perfect, while both the men's and women's basketball teams tipped off their seasons. Stay tuned to Bobcats Weekly.
You don't see the practice.
You don't see the early mornings.
The late nights.
You don't see the blood.
The blood.
The blood.
The blood.
The sweat.
The tears.
You don't see the game before the game.
It's game day.
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 Welcome back to Bobcats Weekly. I'm Nolan Rich. The Quinnipiac men's ice hockey team is off to their best start in history. But the Bobcats wanted to keep their perfect season alive. They would have to defeat the number 7 team in the nation. It's number 4 Quinnipiac hosting Harvard. Second period, Bobcats force a turnover behind the net where the puck goes in front. Tommy Shutt gets the goal. Bobcats on the board first. Then later, Sam Annis from the slot fires and scores his 50th career goal as a Bobcat. Then later on the power play, Eric Smith throws it to the net where Tim Clifton deflects it into the back of the net for the goal. Connor Clifton tacks on empty net as Quinnipiac defeats Harvard by the final of 4-1. Quinnipiac winning their 9th straight after beating Dartmouth. Bobcats will look to stay unbeaten against in-state rival UConn. as in the first period, Bobcats down 2-0, but Sam Annis finally getting the Bobcats on the board with the goal. Then just into the second period, it will be Annis again, his second of the contest. This game is tied up. Then it would be Connor Clifton just seconds later coming in off the wing. He's going to fire and put it in the back of the net. The Bobcats with the lead. And then the Bobcats, can they score 4 goals in 4 minutes? The answer to that, an emphatic yes. Travis St. Denis will bury this one, 4-2 Bobcats. Luke Shiplow will add another one and put the icing on the cake. Quinnipiac scoring 4 power play goals in this one and 6 unanswered as Quinnipiac defeats their in-state rival UConn by the final of 6-2 and extends their unbeaten streak to 11. After a 1-1 tie at home against Princeton, the Quinnipiac women's ice hockey team hit the road in search of a win over the Tigers. Bobcats would trail 1-0 in the second period, and the offense would struggle until TTC and Ferrano. She'll squeeze the shot through, and it will find the back of the net in the third, down 2-1. But on the power play, Sydney Roosler winds up and fires this one into the back of the cage, tying it at 2. From there, it would be all Bobcats. The Tigers trying to clear it. Baumgard keeps in. Puck finds its way to Nicole Brown, and she delivers it to the back of the net. 3-2 KU, Bobcats win by the final 4-2. Roosler with 2 goals and Baumgard with 2 assists in this one. Bobcats are currently ranked 8th in the country after the weekend. Last season, Quinnipiac women's basketball had a season for the ages as they notched an NCAA tournament appearance, a conference championship, and a perfect record in conference play. This season, Quinnipiac has reloaded with one of the youngest rosters in the nation. Quinnipiac opened up the season at West Point, and it's Jasmine Martin 2.0 as Jasmine's little sis Brittany with the drive and layup. And then Brittany showing off the outside range with a jump shot for 3. Then another outside J outside the yard. Swish, she's got her sister's range, but it would be Army in the fourth quarter as they go on a 21-11 run to finish off Quinnipiac. Quinnipiac will drop the season opener on the road by the final score of 67-57. Sarah Shewan led the Bobcats with 18 points, while Brittany Martin had an impressive debut for Quinnipiac with 16. Men's basketball also dropped their season opener, falling to Sacred Heart in the Connecticut Six by the final 76-64. Despite the loss, KU out-rebounded the Pioneer 60-43 as Daniel Harris led the Bobcats with 13 points. This is the second time in his career where Tom Moore has dropped his opening game at Quinnipiac. Many have tried, but only a few can say they've earned the title of Play of the Week. And this week, we head back to the ice as on this breakaway, Michael Gartig robs Tim O'Brien with a beautiful glove save. Gartig only 3 goals allowed this past weekend as he nabs this top play of the week. That'll do it for this edition of Bobcats Weekly. You can follow your favorite Bobcats teams through the holiday season on Twitter at KU Athletics or online at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. I'm your host, Nolan Rich. For all of us here at Bobcats Weekly, have a happy Thanksgiving.